The silver market is showing signs of historic stress, and one of the first major tremors is coming from China. What's happening right now in late 2025 is a severe tightening in the availability of physical silver, with inventories in the critical Shanghai vaults hitting their lowest levels since 2016. This isn't a far-off projection. It's a real-time signal of a deepening supply crisis for the one metal our modern world can't live without. And this isn't just a regional headache for Asian factories. It's the first domino in a chain reaction that's starting to expose a fragile truth about our global supply chain. For years, the world has been using far more silver than it mines, and now we're seeing the consequences surface in the most important industrial hub on the planet. This video will break down the numbers, explain what's happening on the ground in China, and connect the dots to show you why this is a global warning, a sign that the era of cheap, abundant silver may be well and truly over. We'll explore what this means for manufacturing, for the green energy transition, and for the financial markets that have, for too long, ignored the physical reality of this essential metal. China's silver vaults are facing a critical test. As of late 2025, inventories at warehouses connected to the Shanghai Futures Exchange have plummeted to levels not seen since 2016. Some reports in November 2025 showed stockpiles dipping below 446 tons, with one analysis noting a drawdown of more than 300 tons in October alone. This isn't a slow leak, it's a torrent. This drain is the direct result of relentless industrial demand and some extraordinary market dynamics, including record-breaking exports from China to cover shortages elsewhere. It's a major red flag for the worldwide physical silver market, raising fears of a shortage that could cripple global manufacturing and upend markets as we know them. The numbers coming out of China in late 2025 are staggering. For weeks on end, silver has been flowing out of Shanghai's registered vaults at a pace that seems unsustainable. This isn't just paper trading. This is physical metal getting pulled out for use in factories. The Shanghai Futures Exchange, or SHFE, is a critical hub for physical silver in Asia. When its inventories drop this sharply, it means the industrial engine of the world is running hot and demanding more fuel. So, what's driving this drain? Two major forces are at play. First, China is a top-tier consumer of silver, responsible for a massive slice of global demand. Its manufacturing sector is a behemoth, and silver is an irreplaceable ingredient for its most strategic industries. We're talking about the green revolution, every solar panel, every electric vehicle. We're talking about the digital revolution, every smartphone, every AI data center, and every piece of 5G equipment needs silver to work. Demand from the automotive sector alone was projected to approach 90 million ounces by 2025. These aren't luxury goods, they are national priorities for Beijing, and their appetite for silver is relentless and non-negotiable. Second, a bizarre and telling dynamic has unfolded. In October 2025, China exported a record-breaking volume of over 660 tons of silver. Why would a country with such immense industrial needs ship its own stockpiles overseas? The answer is arbitrage. An unusual price difference between markets created an opportunity, making it profitable for Chinese suppliers to ship their metal to ease tightness in other markets like London. This massive outflow was a temporary fix for others, but it has left China's own vaults dangerously low. The result is a market condition known as backwardation, which has been seen in Shanghai. This is an unusual situation where the price for immediate physical delivery of a commodity is higher than the price for delivery in the future. It's the market signaling that it is desperate for metal now because it fears it might not be available later. Adding to the pressure, there has been market chatter about borrowing costs or lease rates spiking to extraordinary levels in London, with some anecdotal reports from traders suggesting annualized rates hit as high as 35% at their peak. For years, the story of silver has been one of two parallel universes: the paper market, where contracts are traded in volumes that dwarf the actual physical supply, and the physical market, where real metal is used to build real things. Some analysts argue what we are witnessing in China is the moment those two universes are colliding. From this perspective, the paper promises are being called in, and the physical reality is starting to bite. The situation in Shanghai is not an isolated event. It is the most visible crack in a foundation that has been weakening for years. The emptying of Shanghai's vaults isn't just China's problem. It's a symptom of a much larger global issue, a structural silver deficit that has been building for years. The simple fact is, for several years, the world has been consuming more silver than it mines and recycles. According to reports from industry leaders like the Silver Institute and Metals Focus, 2025 is on track to be the fifth consecutive year of a structural market deficit. Some analysts project the cumulative deficit since 2021 will be nearly 820 million ounces, almost an entire year's worth of of global mine production that has been consumed from existing stockpiles. For a long time, this deficit was absorbed by drawing down massive, hard-to-track inventories held in vaults around the world, primarily in London and New York. These stockpiles acted as a buffer, masking the growing imbalance. But that buffer is shrinking. Visible inventories in both COMEX and LBMA vaults have been trending downwards from their pandemic-era highs, showing that metal is being steadily pulled out to meet demand. The days of easily raiding the world's cookie jars are coming to an end. China is just the first to show how close to the bottom of the jar we might be. The supply side of the equation offers no easy solutions. Around 70 to 75% of all silver is mined as a byproduct of other metals like copper, lead, and zinc. This means that even if silver prices skyrocket, miners can't just flip a switch and produce more. They are constrained by the economics of the primary metals they are mining. On top of that, the timeline to bring a new primary silver mine from discovery to production can be 10 to 15 years. There is no cavalry coming to the rescue. Mine production has remained stubbornly flat for years, down from its peak around 2016. And while some modest recovery is forecast, it's not nearly enough to bridge the supply gap. This structural deficit is now beginning to manifest as a global manufacturing crisis in slow motion. The green energy transition, hailed as our collective future, is incredibly silver intensive. While manufacturers are constantly trying to reduce the amount of silver in each solar cell, a process called thrifting, the sheer explosion in the number of panels being produced is overwhelming these savings. The same story holds true for the electric vehicle revolution, where each EV uses significantly more silver than a gas-powered car. When physical silver becomes scarce, it's not just investors who feel the pain, it's the entire industrial supply chain. We're talking about the potential for production slowdowns at major manufacturers. The cost of a key component suddenly becomes volatile, or in a worst-case scenario, the component becomes unavailable at any price. This leads to rising costs for everything from an iPhone to a Ford F-150 Lightning. It means the cost of achieving our climate goals goes up. This is the ripple effect. It starts as a delivery issue in a Shanghai warehouse, and it could end with higher prices for consumers and delayed timelines for critical global industries. Some observers believe we're seeing the vulnerability of a just-in-time global economy built on the assumption of infinite resources. Silver has, for decades, been treated as just another industrial input, its price heavily influenced by a massive paper market. Many analysts view that market as operating on what is effectively a fractional reserve basis, with far more paper claims on silver than there are physical ounces to back them. The events in China, from this viewpoint, represent the first major run on a systemic vault in the modern era, where industrial demand is forcing a reckoning with the physical truth. So, where do we go from here? The situation we've described, the draining vaults in China, the multi-year structural deficit, and the inflexible supply doesn't look like a temporary blip. It points toward a fundamental and potentially permanent shift in the silver market. The era of assuming cheap, readily available physical silver may be over. We could be entering a new paradigm, one defined by scarcity, competition for supply, and a necessary repricing of this critical metal. For decades, the price of silver has been dictated more by the paper futures market on exchanges like the COMEX than by the actual fundamentals of physical supply and demand. This created a massive disconnect. While industries were consuming record amounts of silver, the price often languished. That disconnect is becoming harder to sustain. As industrial giants and even nations begin to prioritize securing physical supply over hedging with paper, the physical market will inevitably assert its dominance. This suggests the price will have to rise to a level that either destroys enough demand or incentivizes enough new supply, a process that could be volatile and explosive. This isn't just a theory. The market is already screaming it. Silver prices have surged dramatically in 2025, with gains approaching or even exceeding 90 to 100% year to date and hitting new all-time highs above $50, with some reports noting prices touching $57 an ounce. This isn't just speculative froth, it's a reaction to the physical tightness that is becoming impossible to ignore. Alongside this, we're seeing renewed investor interest, with reports of inflows into silver-backed ETFs as some seek a haven from the storm. Analysts are scrambling to update their models, with some bullish commentators floating price targets of $55, $65, or even higher in the near future if this physical squeeze continues. While these are speculative, they are rooted in the undeniable math of the supply-demand imbalance. The gold-silver ratio, which measures how many ounces of silver it takes to buy 1 ounce of gold, has been falling, signaling that silver is gaining relative strength. This is a classic indicator that investors are beginning to recognize silver's unique position as both a precious metal and a strategic industrial commodity facing a supply crunch. So, what does all this mean for you? The first step is simply to understand what's happening. In a world of inflation, geopolitical instability, and fragile supply chains, understanding the role of real physical assets is more important than ever. The situation unfolding with silver is a masterclass in the difference between paper promises and physical reality. It's important to look beyond the headlines and understand the deep structural forces at play. For those concerned with preserving their wealth, the argument is compelling. The same forces of currency debasement and systemic risk that drive interest in gold are present for silver, but with the added explosive catalyst of an industrial demand crisis. Many are now looking to physical silver, coins, and bars as a way to protect their purchasing power against the very crisis we are describing. This isn't a recommendation to buy or sell, but an urgent call to get informed. It seems the great silver repricing is no longer a question of if, but how soon. The tremors from Shanghai are a warning to the entire world. China's voracious appetite for industrial silver, combined with a global supply chain that was already stretched to its limit, has exposed the fragility of the entire system. We have been living through a unique period in history where one of the world's most critical commodities has been profoundly undervalued, its price held in check by a complex paper market. That period appears to be coming to a close. The convergence of massive structural deficits, inflexible supply, and exploding demand from the green and digital revolutions is creating the perfect storm. This is more than just a commodity story. It's about the foundational materials of the 21st century economy. The events of late 2025 are not the crisis itself, but perhaps they are the trailer for the main event. This is a once-in-a-generation shift, and for those paying attention, it presents both immense risk and historic opportunity. The warning has been sounded. The only question now is, who is listening?